Today's class is of SST and the chapter we are going to read in this class is climatic regions of the Muslim world. So you guys have already studied it in your previous classes as well, and now I am going to introduce what is in this chapter. So the distance covered by the Muslim world from east to west, as we have studied in the previous chapter, and north to south is 15,000 km and 6,000 km simultaneously. This vast area has different climatic regions, you know, that all these countries are in different climatic regions. If Saudi Arabia and the Gulf states are very hot, Pakistan, then Pakistan has a moderate climate as a whole. And moving to further to Malaysia and Indonesia, and they both have heavy rainfall throughout the year, while the Muslim countries of North Africa have a Mediterranean climate. So Muslim countries are further divided, you know, into 8 regions according to their climatic conditions. So these are, I have written it over there, like deserts, semi-deserts and scrubland, tropical grassland, tropical forests, temperate deserts, Mediterranean regions and temperate grasslands, and on the last we have monsoon regions. So in the top of the list we have here deserts. The climate in deserts is hot because there is almost no rainfall. Therefore, there is hardly any agricultural activity or output in these regions. 3/4 of the world's major deserts are in the Muslim countries. For example, the Sahara Desert in Africa makes up 60% of the total desert area in the world. And moving towards on, we have the Thar Desert in Pakistan. We all know we have Thar in Pakistan. In the south, the Somali Desert in Africa, the Kizil Qum in Uzbekistan, the Dasht-e Lut in Iran, and Rabul Khali in Saudi Arabia. These all are the Muslim countries. Though these countries are poor in natural vegetation, but they have valuable minerals, you know, like oil, natural gas resources. And for example, I am going to give the example like Saudi Arabia, the Gulf Strait, Iran, Pakistan. We all know that these countries are quite rich in oil and gas. So this is about the desert, the countries which fall in desert region. Moving on towards semi-desert and scrublands, in these regions temperature is hot during the day and cool at night. It hardly rains in these areas, and it is hence they, it is not suitable for proper crops production. Mostly vegetation is coarse, tough plants and shrubs are produced there. These plants have long roots to go deep down and to get the water from the below the surface. The western part of the Pakistan are semi-deserts, for example, the Thar and Thal. People rear goats and sheep in such areas, and in these areas, wool is produced because there are sheep. The wool from the sheep in Pakistan is good for making carpets. The next region is tropical grasslands. We also call it savanna. These regions lie between the deserts and the tropical forests. The rainfall over there varies between 500 to 1500 millimeters, and the vegetations are there scattered trees and tall grasses. And for a kind of additional information, I would like to tell you that once parts of Pakistan had this type of vegetation, but now the grasslands have been replaced with the crops. And the animals found there are game animals in Africa, for example, lions, giraffes, zebras, and elephants, etc. And the safaris are the tourist attraction over there, as we have game animals in these regions. And now, what is game animals? Game animals is any of the animal which can be hunted for food. And safari park, you all know, we also have some of safari parks in Pakistan as well. It is an area where wild animals are kept in the open and may be observed by the visitors. Driving through the, you know, the visitors are allowed to visit the park in their cars. While driving, they can also spectate the animals roaming around them. The next is tropical forest. The tropical forests are in Central Africa, along the equator and the Southeast Asia. The rainfall over there is heavy, between 1800 to 25 millimeter, or even more than that. So therefore, as there is heavy, almost heavy rainfall throughout the year, so the temperature is very warm there, between 20 to 30 degrees centigrade all the year around. And because of this heavy rainfall, we all know that rainfall is very important for vegetation. So thick forests of tall trees with giant creepers are there. We can see there are tall forests and giant creepers in that forest. Animals are birds and monkeys on the top of the trees. The top of the tree is also called as canopy, as it creates a shade on the earth. And the snake, lizards and insects are below that shade or below that the canopy of that tree. With the teak is also a kind of wood produced in that kind of forest. So teak and other hardwood and rubber are the one of the forest products of these regions. Other crops like sugarcane, cocoa, mangoes, pineapple and the other tropical fruits are also found in tropical forests. And moving towards on the effects of these regions on the human which are being resides in that region are, they are quite healthy because the amount of oxygen the region provides to them is quite sufficient for a healthy life. But diseases like malaria are common and life-threatening in such regions. The next one we have is temperate deserts. These are found in Afghanistan, Central Asian states like Uzbekistan, Azerbaijan and Tajikistan, and some parts of Pakistan as well. The rainfall over these areas varies between 550 to 300 millimeters. Temperature is not as hot as deserts, but quite warm. The vegetation in these areas are acacia and cassia and other coarse plants and grasses, as there is little rainfall in the region. The crops these areas produce are, not very useful. These are dry lands, but crops are produced for irrigation and fertilizers. Uzbekistan is the largest cotton growing state in the world and uses water from the Caspian Sea. Pakistan also has farmlands in its territory. So this was the temperate desert, and the next one is Mediterranean climate regions. Its location is around the shores of the Mediterranean Sea, the coastal areas of Morocco, Algeria, Tunisia, Syria, Turkey, and Lebanon. Agriculture products of these areas are, in this we have one of the most productive climates in the world. These regions are one of the most productive climates in the world, and it produces high value crops for markets of Western Europe. It is a large cotton growing base, and especially the Egyptian cotton is highly prized for its long staple fiber in this cotton. The fruits are grapes, citrus fruits, olives and flowers. These are the famous fruits of this region. And one extra thing, but which is Balochistan, though it is not in the Mediterranean climate region, it is not included in this region, but still it produces a variety of Mediterranean fruits due to a kind of similarity in the climates of Balochistan. The next one is temperate grassland. It is found near Turkey, Syria, Lebanon, parts of Jordan, Iraq and Pakistan. The rainfall is fairly low, about 400 mm per year. Temperature is reasonably warm and excellent for the raiding cattle. Vegetation is long grass, which is also excellent and useful for cattle breeding. And crops are like cereal, like wheat and barley, it's gandum or jaw. Moving on towards the last one is monsoons land. It is the location of monsoon lands. These are present in subcontinent and Southeast Asia, which include Malaysia and Indonesia. The direction of the wind is from northeast for 6 months and from southwest for the rest of the year. The southerly winds bring heavy rainfall over 400 millimeter per year. Vegetation, thick, rich vegetation as in the rainforest. In Pakistan, we have monsoon rainfall from July to September. There is rain mostly in the north. And Pakistan receives less rain because the rain clouds cross India's first. There is a little rain from the westerly depression during December to March. And what is westerly depression? It is an extra tropical storm originating in Mediterranean Sea, and that brings sudden winter rain to Indian subcontinent. So student, this was today's lecture regarding chapter number 2. You are advised to read the chapter from the book as well, so you can grasp the idea from the book as well. And the activity will be attached with the video lecture. So please do your work accordingly. Thank you so much. Have a good day.